So since some of you have asked, I'm going to provide just a little bit more guidance on how to create this chart. So what you see here is the data. It comes pretty much in this format if you download it from the UPenn World Tables, but there might be other sources. So I have here Brazil, Mexico, and the US, and it comes kind of in one long column. And so I just paste these back, you know, next to each other here, so I have the three countries next to each other. Now, what I want to have on the chart ultimately is supposed to look like this. I'm going to show you. This is the chart that I posted as an example. What this shows is the share of Brazilian Brazil's GDP per capita relative to the U.S. So, what does that mean? Well, that means that we're taking Brazil's GDP per capita, which is this number, divided by the US number, and then you see here that's 13%. I'm going to go back. Well, that's the first point here right now, 13%. So I'm going to call that Brazil, and I'm going to call this here Mexico, and obviously this then is Mexico divided by the US. I'm going to format that as percent as well. Take here the time index, and I have my three values. Pull that down here, and I have the time series that I can then, I'm just going to control shift cursor down and insert a line graph. That looks different than, see, I've made a mistake here. I've taken apparently the year here instead of the GDP. So let's take the GDP numbers. That makes a lot more sense. Recalculate this. So it goes. Murphy's Law. Insert the chart and move this chart to the new sheet. There you go. My chart, I reduced the size a bit. I include go in here, insert text box, or you change the chart layout, you know, label it properly and get the thing, the layout that you want. I'm going to use the snipping tool here in on a PC to capture this in, you know, the quickest, easiest way as a JPEG, save it, and then I can upload it. And that's it.